Welcome to Second Take, the show that takes a look at the issues behind the news. South Africa's high demand spectrum has the potential to reshape the country's economy, but how it is allocated and managed will determine its impact. Natasha Odendaal tells us more. Hi Natasha.
Hi.
What is high demand spectrum and how can it contribute to greater economic growth?
Well, there are obviously many forms of spectrum. Spectrum is used in pretty much anything from radio through to GPS. They all use certain bands of spectrum to operate with. The high demand spectrum that we're actually after is in the sub 1 gig, the 1 gig to 6 gigahertz and above 6 gigahertz, which will actually be the key frequencies we need to accelerate economic growth in South Africa. And then this can happen in forms of enabling greater access to rural areas for communication, reduce barrier to entry competition as well. It'll drive down some of our data costs. It'll improve our ease of doing business, global competitive rankings, accelerate technology, fifth generation deployment, IoT as such. It will stimulate innovation to a degree we've never seen before. So therefore we actually need that spectrum urgently.
There have been many delays in the allocation of spectrum. How is this affecting the industry?
Well, other than delaying much of what I've listed already, is actually increasing the costs for operators to deploy communication services. For example, you know, there's been estimates that it's literally doubled the capex for operators to refarm the spectrum that they already have and deploy more base sites so that they can continue to keep up with the demand for data services, for instance. In order to actually keep up with the rapid pace, they need more base stations, they need more spectrum, and none of this can happen without the spectrum they require.
How will government's plans to launch a wireless open area network impact on the allocation of spectrum?
Well, there's some contention around that in industry at the moment because there's a lot of uncertainty surrounding it. I mean, there's been studies that are being done at the moment looking at what would happen if they give all the high demand spectrum to the WOAN, as they call it, and how that would actually operate. But industry hasn't exactly, you know, come on board with it. They're saying that there are certain issues like ownership and private sector involvement that have not been clearly outlined. There's been concerns, obviously, about diverting all the spectrum to the WOAN, and the workability of such structures. I mean, many analysts are actually citing instances where a state-owned wireless network has not worked in the past, and they looked at places like Rwanda, Russia, Kenya, Mexico, where it hasn't worked, or it hasn't worked through to completion, where they've actually wasted quite a bit of money, and the wireless network has never taken off. They indicate that it's a poor model to actually operate on, and we'd rather be better that instead of allocating, if they are going to pursue the WOAN, instead of allocating all the spectrum to that network, strategically, you know, auction it off, or try and look at it in a different way, try and develop a new model of making both of them workable. The study that I was referring to earlier was a CSIR study that's actually sitting in a cabinet at the moment. That study had looked on the spectrum availability. It had, you know, analyzed any all possibilities of what the WOAN would actually need. So we're actually waiting to see what cabinet will say about this study. When it's released, we can look at that again further.
Thank you. That's the Second Take show for this week. Thank you for watching and join us again next time for more news analysis.